Lal Pachalaji, honorable ministers, excellencies, leaders from the private sector, eminent business persons from around the world, ladies and gentlemen, a warm good morning to you all. Thank you, Prime Minister, for hosting this important summit and inviting me to speak a few words of this inaugural session this morning. Let me also extend warm welcome to our distinguished guests who have traveled all the way to Kathmandu to attend this summit. I am confident that the deliberations in the summit and various instruments of cooperation and partnership that will be exchanged during the summit will pave the way to greater flow of investment in Nepal. Nepal is still a least developed country. We confront huge development challenges. While our country has huge potential for development, we lack adequate capital and appropriate technology to realize development benefits. In this context, the convening of this high-level event assumes a particular significance. My party, Nepali Congress, initiated economic reform in Nepal back in 1990. Nepali Congress government liberalized the economy, invited private sectors, and created a conducive environment for foreign investment. During that short span of period, our government reoriented the policies, revised old laws, brought in new laws, realized the public expenditure and initiated the liberal income tax regime. Nepal's investment regime is now liberal in terms of sector open for foreign investment, tax policies, and repatriation earnings. Amongst all sectors are open to foreign investment. Agriculture, tourism, infrastructure, development, mines, minerals, manufacturing, tourism, hydropower and ITR, some of the key sectors where domestic and foreign investment will have transformative impact. Foreign investment is protected by domestic law and various international instruments to which our country is party. I have come to know that the government has expressed its willingness to conclude bilateral investment protection agreement with various countries to promote Nepal as an attractive destination for investment. Flexible our law, demographic dividends with substantial share of young and energetic populations, reliable supply of electricity availability of local raw materials also contribute to make production low cost compared to to other high wages countries in the region. We have established one stop service that includes the Investment Board of Nepal for large scale project under the public private partnership Department of Industries for other small and medium sized investment projects. We have streamlined process to save time and energy for the registration of companies and putting them into operation relatively within a short period of time. Less bureaucracy means faster decision making and quicker approval of proposals. Moreover, all major political parties remain committed to promote foreign investment in Nepal and come together to foster consensus on key investment related issues. During my tenure as the Prime Minister, we implemented crucial reform. We aimed at the promoting foreign investment, boosting tourism, harnessing the potential of hydropower, revitalizing industries and agriculture. As the reform was not completed, I believe that the present government will continue to reform initiatives and create more conducive environment for the private sectors. Internal market is expanding with the increase in income. The peoples of external market is accessible due to geographical proximity and concessional trading facilities that we receive from our neighbors and other countries, other partners. Our two neighbors, India and China, offer huge market opportunity for Nepal. We also have supportive trading relationship with USA and EU. As former Prime Minister and the President of the largest and oldest Democratic Party, Nepal Congress, I would like to convey the following message. We pursue liberal economic policies where market and the private sectors have an important role to play in advancing economic development under a democratic framework. The government plays a facilitating role and creates an environment that is conducive for the investment and business without losing its responsibility to ensure social justice and inclusive representation of all segments of Nepalese society. We live in the era of intense competition of investment. This means we need to be more attractive and competitive in providing intensive and protecting investment. Money goes where it is treated well. We continue pursuing reform in a coherent and practical manner to adjust our investment regime in the light of changes in the internal and external economic environment. We do not pursue disciplinary policy vis-a-vis foreign investors. We are treated poor with national investors. We welcome foreign investors as our valued guests. They are convincing example we provide that foreign investment in Nepal is profitable. Some of the multinationals working in Nepal have been able to repatriate a good amount of dividend over the years. Please come to Nepal and invest in our economy. That will be beneficial to you and our people. We will provide you a full protection, assure that our sustained cooperation from start to finish. We will cherish our partnership for development and prosperity. Your contribution in supporting Nepal in its endeavors to transform the economic landscape will be highly valued. The time is of essence. Nepal has huge untapped potentials. I believe that with our common efforts, we can make a difference. I wish our international guests a pleasant stay in Nepal and the productive deliberations. I also wish to thank all the success to the summit. Thank you very much. Jai Nepal.
Thank you, sir. Thank you indeed for